In lesson six, students are asking the question, what impacts how students experience a pandemic? As a class, students discuss why the data we saw in lesson five looked different for different places and what might impact whether or not people follow guidelines. One point we want to elicit from this conversation is that communication and the spread of information could have impacted the spread of the COVID-19 virus. Identifying, evaluating, and using information effectively in communication and decision-making is an essential skill. First, students look at a newspaper from 1914 and discuss how misinformation during a pandemic was present more than 100 years ago. Together, we then think about and analyze how this happened during the COVID-19 pandemic. Students create a set of criteria for determining whether or not information is reliable, and then select a piece of information to analyze in groups. The class then comes together to discuss their analysis and to talk about how misinformation can impact people's behavior. Together, we see that information can be a threat when it intends to cause harm to a community, and that it can be a protection when it decreases risk and increases trust in a community. Misinformation is one factor that can influence how people experience a pandemic. At the start of the unit, students encountered three locations from completely different regions of the United States that were used as an anchoring place for this unit. A breadth of racial, ethnic, and economic differences are represented by these selected locations. In this lesson, we come back to these communities. Using the set of factors we brainstormed in lesson one, we come back and think about how these factors could act as threats or protections in a community. Students work together to explore data for one of the communities, including location and demographics, employment and production, social needs, and health risks. Students then make sense of what that data can tell us about both the threats and protections a community might experience during a crisis like the COVID-19 pandemic. We figure out how these factors we've been thinking about throughout the unit can act as threats or protections as people experience events that cause them to need to take risks like going to work during a pandemic. What we are missing is how these factors came to be important for understanding people's experiences during the pandemic and other disasters and diseases. Students read about how threats and protections came to be in communities and create a class model to explain how investment or disinvestment in a community over time can lead to greater or less access to information, education, healthcare, jobs, safe living conditions, and healthy food, which can then lead to more or less protection and people experiencing fewer or more threats, especially during a pandemic. Students wrap up lesson six with a thought experiment in their SEL journals focused on how systemic and structural issues impact people's experiences during disasters like the pandemic or a massive power outage.